हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस बर्थ कंट्रोल और कंट्रासेप्शन। इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस्ड द प्रॉब्लम्स एंड स्ट्रेटजीज। स्ट्रेटजीज आर द एक्शन प्लान्स एंड इवन द एग्जीक्यूशन ऑफ दीज प्लानिंग्स, दैट इज प्रोग्राम। नाउ वी विल डिस्कस सॉल्यूशन टू दोज प्रॉब्लम्स। ओके, व्हाट इज बर्थ कंट्रोल or contraception? The intentional prevention of the conception or conceiving or fertilization by natural or artificial means is called contraception or birth control. Birth control is the only solution to the problem of to overcome the problem of population explosion and even that many other problems that we have discussed earlier. People should be motivated to have the smaller families by using many contraceptive methods. Motivation done through reproductive health care programs. We have discussed the reproductive health care programs are developed by the government. So through that, through arranging many programs, the people can be motivated. Some important measures taken by government, like the legal marriageable age is fixed. Now it is fixed to 18 years for girls and 21 years for boys, which was previously 15 years for girls and 19 years for boys. Now it is increased to 18 and 21 for girls and boys respectively, providing the incentives to the couples of smaller families, providing the education and the providing the reservation, free education and reservation in the education and occupation or employment of their children, the children of the smaller families, those who are having the green card or blue card. Even the government is started providing the ration at subsidized rate. Now let us know how the birth control methods act. The birth control methods act by preventing the fertilization. That means it prevents the sperm transport from reaching the ovum, preventing the sperm transport from reaching the ovum means prevents the fertilization. Simply we can say preventing fertilization. That is the at the beginning of the pregnancy, means which is the beginning of the pregnancy. As you have discussed the definition of the contraception or birth control, that intentional prevention of conception or fertilization. That means when the sperm reaches, egg is in the fallopian tube, when the sperm reaches, then only it can reaches the ovum, then only it can fertilize. If the transport of sperm is prevented on the way, then the fertilization cannot be done. Simple, very simple. Preventing ovulation. If sperm is reached but ovum is not there, then also fertilization can be prevented. So preventing ovulation, some methods are there, those who prevent the ovulation. And preventing implantation of blastocyst occurs. The early embryonic stage blastocyst, so preventing the early embryo. preventing the implantation of, okay, implantation of the blastocyst, that is the early embryo, in the uterus where it is implanted in the uterus. So mainly what you will remember, preventing the, how the birth control methods act, by preventing the fertilization, as preventing the transport of sperm to ovum, preventing the ovulation, preventing the, if suppose fertilization is done, then preventing the implantation. Okay, three major things are there. There are different kinds of birth control methods that act on different point of the process of conception. Process of different points of the process of conception. Conception, let's get clear about this term. Conception means fertilization. Fertilization means the beginning of the pregnancy. So, what I am meant for? We can think for, that is fertilization. And fertilization, even after the fertilization is done, if implantation cannot be done, then pregnancy is not continued. Pregnancy is not done. That means is pregnancy is prevented. So conception means preventing it acts at the beginning of the pregnancy, that is at the time of fertilization. It just breaks the fertilization, or it makes the uterus hostile for the implantation. So at what point? It may prevent or stops the fertilization, or it prevents or stops the implantation, the birth control methods. The methods, prevent the sperm transport, they are the physical barriers. We will discuss now the different type of barriers, even the chemical barriers. Chemical methods, physical barrier methods, okay? Methods like condom, that male and female condom, diaphragm, cervical cap, vault, etc. That we will discuss. Chemical methods, the spermicide containing creams, tablets, preventing ovulation. It is done by using the contraceptive method, that is the oral pills. Pills that are containing, releases the hormones. Preventing implantation, generally done by IUDs or IUCDs, intrauterine devices, or intrauterine contraceptive devices. Now let us discuss the various methods of the birth control. Before going to various methods of birth control or contraceptives, let us know how the government has introduced the family planning programs to eligible couples. The process of bringing eligible couples under the family planning programs is called couple protection. Okay? Couple protection. The rate of couple protection is also maintained. People are, as we have already discussed, the people are motivated to use the contraceptives. So how it is done? Through mass media like the television, radio, news, newspaper, magazines, posters, we have discussed like Hum Do Hamare Do, Ya Do Ya Teen Bas, it was in the beginning, hoardings, etc. given in school college curriculum. It is already introduced about the animal reproduction, that human reproduction and the reproductive health as you are studying right now, the lectures, the books, but through the personal contacts by the family welfare and community health workers, family welfare and community health workers, by the students, by the educated persons. And the knowledge is also given about the contraceptives, different contraceptives, that how these contraceptives are ideal. The ideal contraceptives are, they should be easily available. The contraceptives should effective with no or less effect. Contraceptive or the birth control methods. The different birth control methods of contraceptives should be easily available. And that should be effective with no or less. We can't say without. No or less side effects. No interfere in the sexual desire. No interfere with the sexual desire or sexual act of the users. So far we have discussed the family planning can be done through various contraceptive or birth control methods. These methods are of two types, that is temporary and permanent. The permanent method is also known as sterilization or terminal method. Terminal means end. In which case the terminal method or that permanent birth control, they opt the couples, those who have two children and do not want any more child, then they can opt for that to the permanent method. The temporary method, which is also known as spacing method. Spacing method means to keep gap between two children. These are also various types, barrier method, chemical method, the hormonal method, the IUCDs, IUCDs, intrauterine contraceptive devices or intrauterine devices, IUDs or IUCDs, then natural method, hormonal method, again of various type, hormonal pills are there, emergency pills are there, hormone injections and subcutaneous implants. Even subcutaneous implants, they are also releasing a small device, that matchstick-like device, which is releasing the hormone, and they are implanted, means placed below the skin. That's why subcutaneous. We will discuss separately. Yes, barrier methods. Barrier methods, they prevent the fertilization. Even though normal sperms and ovum are released, or they are produced and released, then also they do not mate. Okay, thus it prevents the fertilization. These barrier methods, the devices are available for both male and female. These are the most beneficial contraceptive. The barrier method is the most beneficial contraceptive. Why? Let me tell you that it protects from sexually transmitted diseases. That is STIs, sexually transmitted infections, that including AIDS, acquired immunodeficiency. Sorry, here it should be capital S. Sexually transmitted diseases including AIDS. In NCERT it is given STDs and AIDS. AIDS is also one of the STD. So we can write down including AIDS. It provides protection against the pregnancy. It protects the pregnancy also. Because during pregnancy means that embryo is growing, the fetus is growing within the uterus, then it also protects the, because it does not allow this barrier. Because of this barrier, semen, the body fluid, does not enter into the female reproductive tract. That's why it does not carry the pathogens of the STD. The condom, the most famous popular barrier is the condom. Condom is made of a thin rubber or latex. Latex is the plant product. Okay, a thin rubber like sheet. Okay, tie down. Made up of thin rubber like rubber or latex sheath. Generally, the male condom is made up of the rubber like latex sheath. Whereas the female condoms are made up of polyurethane and nitrile or nitrile. The most popular condom, male condom available is the Nirodh, and the first female condom was introduced in 1992, that is Femidom, that is made up of nitrile. Nitrile is the gloves are made up of that type of synthetic latex or rubber like substance, plastic synthetic one, soft plastic. And Femsil is another brand. Now let us discuss the features. The male condom covers the penis in the male. That is external condom. Male condoms are external condom. Whereas the female condom covers the vagina and cervix. That is in the female. That is internal condom. Because it covers the genital tract or female reproductive tract, that is from vagina to cervix, but internally, placed internally. That's why the female condoms are internal condoms. It creates the barrier. The same thing is we have discussed the features of the barrier method, that barrier of contraceptives. The condoms, the male or female condoms, they create the barrier to stop the, to obstruct the entry of semen into the female genital tract. Even though ejaculation is done by the male, the semen is not entering into the female genital tract. If the Here is the, suppose, penis. The condom remains like this. So what happens? Even the ejaculation is done, the semen remain over here. So no entry of semen into the female genital tract. Here even the, if the male partner is infected from the STDs like AIDS, etc., any other AIDS or any other pathogen, one is infected, then also the pathogen remains over here in the semen. Okay. Then in case of the females, this is place, this is the type of the female condom, where two rings are there here. Two rings or rings are, ring shaped rings are there. The internal one is closed. Here I have shown you. The internal is closed and that is fit over the cervix. Condoms are used before the coitus. And what are the side effects? The side effects are, they are not reusable. They are disposable. And if it is required to be used during to make the gap between two children, it is not possible. They cannot be used for a longer period to keep the gap between the children. for time, it is used only for the time being, because if it is used for a longer period, it can create the rashes, irritation, etc. So one cannot use for a longer time. So this is the drawback or side effect of the condom. But it is most beneficial because it prevents the STDs. It protects from STDs and protect the pregnancy. Just remember, very important part. And diaphragm, cervical cave, vault cave, these are female barriers. All these three are female barriers. Let me write down. These are female barriers. Okay, for female. They prevent fertilization. These are also important. And how these barriers act? By preventing the fertilization. Because they block the semen to enter into the female genital tract. These are also made up of the rubber or synthetic latex. Silicon. Made up of silicon. Covers the cervix and used before the coitus. And it should be left in the place at least for 6 hours even after coitus. What is the reason? If the cervix is here, then this is a cave upon cape-like. We will see the proper three-dimensional picture. We will go through that. Just imagine, this is the vagina, and if some leakage is there, after coitus, if the sperms remain attached to the vaginal wall, then it may enter into the uterus afterward. So it should be at least left in the place for 6 hours, so that even if the sperms are left over here in the acidic medium of the vagina, they will be killed. And remember, these are used with the spermicidal jellies, creams, foams to make it more efficient. Okay? To make it more efficient, the spermicide, that means to kill the sperm. CIDE, side or cidal, means we can understand to kill. Spermicidal, to kill the sperm, to destroy the sperm. And the most important one is, it is reusable. These are the diaphragm, cervical caves, vault caves are reusable. So most important is they are reusable, and when they are used with the chemical barriers like the spermicides, the jelly screen foams, it becomes more efficient. It also protects from STDs. It prevents the entry of, it does not allow the entry of the semen into the uterus. That's why. We were discussing about diaphragm, cervical cap and vault cap. And all these three are almost similar, only different in shape and names are different. All are made up of the rubber or latex like substance or silicon. They all the same, like the other condoms, they prevent the fertilization, blocks the sperms to meet the ovum. They have no dangerous side effect and use with this for a spermicide. And these are reliable barrier device if used properly, and they protect from the STDs. also they protect from STDs. This is derived from vaccine, soft rubber cover and use based spermicide. It covers the cervix. Only shape is wider and the height is small and it covers the cervix, uterus. Okay, because the wider part it covers towards the uterus part. Cervical cap, it is the miniature of the diaphragm, narrower, but it's a because of the narrow structure, it looks like the longer one, but somewhat it is longer, covers the cervix closely, used with the spermicide, same thing, and more effective and can remain for a longer time in the place than the diaphragm. The vault cap, it is hemispheric dome shaped, all three are dome shaped, okay, and it is half sphere, hemispheric dome shaped cup with thick rim. Here is also thick rim is there. This is the rim. This is the rim. In vault it is among three. The vault is having a thick rim. And this is also rim. And same made up of rubber or plastic, prevent portulation. They use with spermicide, fit into the vaginal vault, covers the cervix. This what you have to understand. What is vaginal vault? Okay, for that I have drawn a diagram over here. You know the if it is the uterus, the cervix and is extending into the wider inner part of the vagina, this is called the arc shaped, the larger arc shaped space of the inner part is called vaginal vault. It is named so because it is fit into the vaginal vault. Of course, it also covers the cervix. This is the cervix and this part of the uterus. So it is vaginal vault because it fit into that vaginal inner part of the inner wider arc shaped part of the vaginal canal. And it also covers the cervix. Next, we will go with the chemical method. Okay, all these are same, but the most important one already we have discussed that these are reusable. That's why very much important. All these three are, these are reusable. And as we have discussed in the beginning of the barrier method, these barrier contraceptives, they protect from, these are protecting from the STDs. Let us have a look at the different barrier contraceptives. This is the female condom. This is the closed end with a small ring and a large ring, the open end with a large ring. It is fit into the vaginal canal completely. It covers the vaginal canal and covers the cervix, and the open end is extended outside out of the vaginal canal of the vagina. And see the male condom, the diaphragm, and it also covers the cervix. The sperms are deposited here during ejaculation, but they cannot enter into the uterus. It blocks the sperm from entering into the cervix. Before using the spermicidal jelly cream or use, here another position, it is shown that this is the vaginal canal and here the cervix is covered by the diaphragm. Here are the cervical caps, cervical cap, this is vault, vault cap. Before using this, before the coitus, the spermicidal cream or jelly is applied. This is the cervical cap, how it covers the cervix.